This is the end video for the July 13th Sunday. We got a good healthy surf. The perhaps tomorrow I will find something. One never knows. Well, the tide is going out. The fog seems to be moving out. But it's just too foggy for the big camera. And looking around here, we got some ducks out there. I don't know if you can see them or not, but it won't do me much good to try to zoom in. This is only a 3-power zoom. Yeah, it was truly a miserable filming day. I'm going to fix this zoom here. Well, I was hoping to spot a piece of pipe stem down here somewhere. You're going to spot on the beach with the dredger at work. It would have been, I would not have been surprised to see a piece of pipe stem up here. It's going to be well, the low tide is going to be, the peak of it will be midnight. So that's not going to be fairly strong currents out there. For a surf like this, there's such strong currents. Don't have to worry about the little blue camera getting wet. Ha ha! One of these days when there's a storm, I'll be able to actually film the storm waves. Some of them are quite impressive. I think I know where some of the baby ducks might have gone to. The herons, the great blue herons, will eat baby ducks as well. I've seen, saw a video or two on it. That might explain the mysterious disappearances. Every once in a while, you'll see some splashes come up. Oh, no. I'm always hoping to get lucky and find something down here on this pebble part. I see this beach is dug up a bit. The wave action dug up the beach good. Well, the sea isn't angry today. When it gets angry, that's when the storm waves are smashing into everything. And I have to remember. I want to get this piece right here. A piece of Warren quartz. Right there, that's the remains of an ancient coral bed. You never know what you're going to find. The tide can toss up anything. lot of interesting minerals, and the gates are all piled up here. The fog is pulling out. Slowly but surely, the fog is pulling out. Yeah. I remember filming and walking along here and finding pieces of fossil coral. But that doesn't happen all the time. That's only rare. Because most of the things that wind up here get all, well, after a while you get banged around on these big rocks and there's not much left. And right here, that's a remnant of the nature coral bed. When diatoms die, when coral dies, this looks like a, it used to be diatoms, I think. They leave a glassy substance, and when enough of them die, it forms a flint or a chert. A flint is more the term I'm looking for. Now, right there, that is the remains of an ancient coral bed. Oh yes, there are all kinds of remnants of ancient coral beds here. The agates, as people know them, A-G-A-T-E, are basically fossil corals. And there's all kinds of them on this beach. But I'm looking for fossils that can be handed over to the school. Collected and handed to the school. Fossil corals that can be easily identified, the same as the plant fossils. Look. And walking around on these rocks is pretty hazardous because this is slippery like eel skin. So so you have to be extremely cautious. You don't want to go running on this section of beach, or you're going to be on your butt really soon, quicker than you realize, and probably with a broken ankle. So just take your time. Oh, that's a wet algae with wet clay, so that's even slipperier. So what I'm looking for is small artifacts and fossil corals. But I like the fossil corals that you can find in the shales, because all the details are much stronger, much more clear. Sedimentary. Yeah, this is a sedimentary stone. One thing of a sedimentary stones, a conglomerate, you can see everything that's pretty much in it. You might be able to make out those ducks there. They're not far away, but this is only just a weak camera and it's quite foggy. Let's see if I can get those ducks in. Yeah. They're here to get a feed. Hello, duckies. Now, if I had the big camera here, I could probably zoom right in on them. They're feeding on the... They're not very afraid of people, are they? They swim along and dabble to feed and swim along. Yeah. Well, now... We might stand a better chance for moving in, and the camera is no longer zoomed. Yeah, they're not afraid at all. There's the two. The babies and adults. Oh my god. The young ones are getting really big. They're all... Pretty soon they'll be flying. Pretty soon they're going to be flying. Going with the flock. Alright, let's... this stuff right here. It's a gate. It used to be part of coral beds, but it's all broken up. And there's granites, all kinds of broken river granite. Interesting stuff. But I didn't find my pipe stem or trade bead or fossil, or the fossils that I wanted to find. I would kind of like to find some boro fossils too. They're always neat. Fog has just added back in a little bit. I can tell because the video is getting foggy. This was a horrible friggin' day for filming. A very horrible day. Yeah, we have conglomerates here, igneous stone, limestone, limestone is a type of shale, but we have different kinds of shales here too. Yeah, sometimes when you're walking up around here, you've always got to have your trekking pole, hiking stick planted, and one foot planted securely at all times. So when you're moving the other foot, if you slip when you're trying to land that other foot, you always have two other sources of balance to rely on. Otherwise, you're going to end up slipping, falling, and you don't really want to do that. Found a piece of calcite. No, I think that's quartz. A little piece of quartz. No, that's way too late to be quartz. I just heard the sound it made when it fell. I think it's calcite. Calcite is basically fossil salt. What's this here? Nope. Just a beat up piece of old wood.